Not too bad.
Labor Day weekend for us.
Yeah, not too bad for us. Different story, obviously, in the Bahamas. Just a terrible day there. One of the strongest hurricanes to ever hit the Bahamas. And we still have hurricane warnings in effect for most of that island chain. We're also looking at hurricane warnings now in effect for a major part of the east coast of Florida, near Cocoa Beach, down towards Sebastian and Fort Pierce, almost all the way down to West Palm Beach, where there's a tropical storm warning. But the hurricane warning means that hurricane force wind gusts will be felt within the next 24 to 36 hours, likely by Tuesday morning there in Florida. But this is still a major Category 5 storm with maximum sustained winds at 185 miles per hour. It's still about 155 miles to the east of West Palm Beach. Look how close this hurricane gets. Now, this is the official track, but the cone of uncertainty still covers parts of the east coast of Florida. So that means that it's still within the realm of possibility that we get a landfall here near West Palm Beach, up toward Titusville, somewhere in this general area along the Space Coast. But most of the major models, computer models, keep this just offshore, but then recurve it along the U.S. coast from the coast of Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina by the end of the week. And this could impact several people up and down the southeast coast. Look at the wind forecast here. You see these colors of orange. That's over 110 miles per hour. Look how close that gets by Tuesday afternoon to Melbourne, Florida, for example. Before this storm takes that turn to the north, it could be very close to Savannah by the middle of the week with hurricane force winds. A very close call up and down the southeast coast. Now, one thing we know for sure, it's going to rain a whole lot in Florida, and some areas here in northeast Florida could easily pick up 7 to 10 plus inches of rain, maybe even more than that. Looking outside here, we have lots of sunshine at Clyde Warren Park. We're in the mid-90s. It's a hot afternoon, and it's going to be hot again tomorrow. Now, temperatures will start in the mid-70s for Labor Day morning. Highs in the mid-90s tomorrow. And so a trip to the swimming pool or an area lake, not a bad idea for the holiday. As you go back to work on Tuesday, it's still going to be hot with highs in the mid to upper 90s. And I do anticipate that we're talking about temperatures well above normal for the first week of September. In fact, I think we'll be in the upper 90s and maybe even 100 coming up Friday and Saturday. So summer not wanting to let go, even though tomorrow is the unofficial end of summer. Very hot for the week ahead and no rain in sight, at least through next Sunday.